America's combat mission in Iraq is officially over. But is that comforting to local families who still have loved ones serving overseas? News 5's Brian Hamrick asked that question to the families of local patriots.
Yeah, the end of combat operations in Iraq, but for many families, the fear of what war can bring continues.
For those with family still serving in the military, there's no end to concern, still no end to the anxiety.
It's not an end to anything until my thought is they all come home.
Renee Gerber knows all too well. Her son, Private Andrew Gerber, is a mortar specialist now serving in Afghanistan.
To say that we're pulling troops out of there does not mean everybody gets to come home. And, you know, I don't want people to forget about our soldiers over there.
They haven't here at the Yellow Ribbon Center, where today and every week they continue to send out dozens of boxes to the troops.
You know, they're still in harm's way.
Package is now going to Afghanistan instead of Iraq. A different address on the box, but the mission here is no different.
We will be here until everybody quits supporting us or all the guys come home, one way or the other. That's our mission.
For those who had been serving in Iraq, the biggest change expected is a change in war zone destinations.
Pulling troops out is all well and good, but let's follow one of those soldiers and see how long they get to stay home.
Your guess is?
Not very long.
For many, what's described as the end is just a good beginning. And many military families say until they can stop adding names to memorials like this one, no one can rest easy. Brian Hamrick, News 5.